Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to St. Paul Lutheran Church on this, the second Wednesday in the second Sunday in the season of Advent. We're marking time using our Advent wreath. We've lit a second candle as we are in the second week. And you'll notice at the back there is a banner on the side wall that says Bethlehem Candle. And the Bethlehem Candle represents the faith that Mary and Joseph had as they traveled to the city of Bethlehem to participate in the census. During their pregnancy. Today we'll be using Divine Service Setting 5, which is found in the St. Paul Worship Book that looks just like this if you want to use your one-page bulletin. It's also in the hymnal, but there's a couple of variations, so it would be better to use the St. Paul Worship Book for that. And for those of you who grab the full bulletin on the way in, everything's printed there for you. For those that are worshiping with us from afar, we welcome you in the name of the Lord. If this is your first time joining us, my name is Reverend Louis Bolt. I'm the pastor here at St. Paul Lutheran Church in Hammond, Louisiana. We're glad you found us and were able to join us. If you haven't already done so, please click the link in the description of the video. It will take you to a PDF of the service so that you can follow along and participate wherever you happen to be. Congregational responses are indicated by a C in bold. At times, I will invite the congregation to stand with the understanding that as you are able. So if you're not able to stand, it's okay. Remain seated during those times, and it's perfectly okay. There will be, we rejoice as God continues to do the work that he promises to do by growing his kingdom. And we'll be welcoming in a new family into membership this day before the prayer of the church. We'll invite them forward. Congregational responses are indicated in the rites and reception of new members printed in your bulletin. And then for those of you using the St. Paul Worship Book, that's found on the orange insert in that book. All right. I think that's it as far as the answers go. So let us begin with a word of prayer. Gracious Lord, Heavenly Father, you have called us to this place to hear your word. May you be at work through the word that is read and proclaimed in this place, that it may lead us to repentance, that we may be turned around and be brought back to you, so that we may be restored into a right relationship through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, who gave his life for us, who died on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins, and rose from the dead on the third day, so that we may have the sure and certain hope of everlasting life. All those who pray in his dear name, amen. Our opening hymn this day is hymn 343, and on each of the hymns, there will be a brief introduction.
Let every hand
Son, that by his coming we may be enabled to serve you with pure minds, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated as our service continues, as we speak our verse of the month, which is found in your bulletin. It's from Isaiah chapter 62, verse 11.
Behold, the Lord has proclaimed to the end of the earth. Say to the daughter of Zion, behold, your salvation comes. Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense is with him.
Our service will continue with the readings.
The Old Testament reading for the second Sunday in Advent is from Isaiah chapter 11. There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his roots shall bear fruit. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his waist, and faithfulness the belt of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion and the fattened calf together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, and their young shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. Pardon me. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as water covers the sea. In that day the root of Jesse, who shall stand as a signal for the peoples, of him shall the nations inquire, and his resting place shall be glorious. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our service continues as we speak responsively verses of Psalm 72 with parts from the entire congregation indicated by C and in bold. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the royal son.
May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice.
Let the mountains bear prosperity for the people and the hills in righteousness.
May he defend the cause of the poor of the people. Give deliverance to the children of the needy and crush the oppressor.
May they fear you while the sun endures and as long as the moon throughout all generations.
May he be like rain that falls among the grass, like showers that water the earth.
In his days may the righteous flourish and peace abound till the moon be no more.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The epistle reading is from Romans chapter 15. For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that through endurance and through the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope. May the God of endurance and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Jesus Christ, that together you may with one voice glorify God and Father of our Lord, Jesus Christ. Therefore, welcome one another as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. For I tell you that Christ became a servant to the circumcised to show God's truthfulness in order to confirm the promises given to the patriarchs and in order that the Gentiles might glorify God for his mercy. As it is written, therefore I will praise you among the Gentiles and sing your name. And again it is said, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. And again, praise the Lord, all you Gentiles, and let all the peoples extol him. And again Isaiah says, the root of Jesse will come, even he who arises to rule the Gentiles, in him will the Gentiles hope. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And for those of you using the one-page bulletin, I just noticed there's an error on the tab, so I apologize, but the next part of our service will be the gospel reading, and the hymn of the day will be after the sermon. So I invite you to stand as you are able. Let us return to the Lord our God, for he is gracious and merciful and abounding in steadfast love and covenant faithfulness. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the third chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. For this is he who was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah when he said, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Now John wore a garment of camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. Then Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region about the Jordan were going out to him, and they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming for baptism, he said to them, you brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruit in keeping with repentance, And do not presume to say to yourselves, we have Abraham as our father. For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children for Abraham. Even now the axe is laid to the roots of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but he who is coming after me is mightier than I, whose sandals I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor and gather his wheat into the barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Our service will continue as we confess our common faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
In the name of our King who comes and will come again, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the sermon. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. During this Advent season, we're meditating on the topic of end times living, based on our appointed epistle reading for the day. And that is true for this day. And we're going to be focusing in on how we live with hope and harmony. Now, hope in the Bible is to look forward with confidence, to look forward with confidence to that which is going to be beneficial. Harmony in the Bible is having like-mindedness. Now, I don't know about you, but when I think about hope and harmony in that context, and I look at the world around us, a world that is filled with division, I don't see much hope. I don't see much harmony in the world around us. You see, we live in a world that's divided by political ideologies and ethnicities and all sorts of other E's that are too long to go through this morning. But because of that, there's an apparent lack of hope and a lack of harmony in this world that we find ourselves in. But it's not just those countries that are around us. It's also in our own country. You see, in our country, we've witnessed lots of discord. Discord in public conversation. Discord within different racial groups within our country, discord within our own households sometimes about certain matters. And in the face of the discord, we might be wondering, where's the hope? And where in the world is the harmony? Because I don't see it sometimes. But it's not just the world, it's not just our country. The fact is, it's our own congregation. You see, we too in this congregation battle disappointments. We battle things that don't go the way we wanted them to go, the way we thought they should go, the way we hoped that they should go. And in the face of the disappointment, we might start to question the hope and the harmony. We don't seem to be walking with like-mindedness sometimes. This is the trouble that we see in the world that we live in. In this fallen, broken creation, there doesn't seem to be hope. There doesn't seem to be harmony. But the truth is, we're not alone. I mean, think about the appointed epistle reading. St. Paul writing to Christians in the city of Rome. He's never been there just yet, but the Holy Spirit was at work through people to share the good news of Jesus the Christ. the one who gave his life on the cross for the forgiveness of sins, the one who rose from the dead on the third day so that there will be a sure and certain hope of everlasting life. He's writing to them, and he tells them to have hope and to live in harmony. Now, why in the world would the Apostle Paul need to tell them to live in hope and harmony? Well, perhaps because they're not. Perhaps it's because they don't have confidence in that which is going to be beneficial. They don't have like-mindedness about the things that they've heard and the things that they believe. But the Apostle Paul writes them to live their lives in the end times that they find themselves in with hope and with harmony. Now he goes on to talk about why they have hope. And he goes on to talk about why they have harmony. This is the grace in the text, my dear friends, because the Apostle Paul tells them about God's holy word, the scriptures of old. That's where they have their hope, Paul says. That's why they can live in harmony, because God has sent the one to fulfill all of the promises of the Holy Scriptures. Those things that were written down in former days, days of old, they were written down for instruction, so that through endurance in God's word, they may live lives of hope, of something more beneficial to come, and they can live in harmony with one another, because they, my dear friends, they have been brought together and united in Christ Jesus. You see, by God's grace through faith in Christ, they have become part of the body of Christ. They are the holy ones of God. Not that their works made them holy, but because of God's grace, he credits them and tells them that they are holy. They are those whose sins have been washed away because of the blood of the Lamb. The blood that Jesus shed for them. 2,000 years, well, not 2,000 years, just probably about 20 years, if that, before Paul is writing this letter. And he's reminding them that Jesus has done this work for them. That through him, who fulfilled the law in their place, he bore all their sins upon himself on the cross, and he was raised up from the dead so that they would have a hope of everlasting life. You see, they have been brought into the body of Christ by faith and baptism. They've been united with Christ in their baptism as they were baptized into his death and resurrection, as Paul says earlier in chapter 6 of his letter. And because of that, because they're part of the body of Christ, they can live with hope of a confidence of something better to come and of like-mindedness in what they believe. And the same is true for you and I. We are those who have been united in Christ through faith and baptism as well. As God brought you to this place, maybe not this place for you, but to the place of the baptismal font where you were baptized, God was uniting you in Christ Jesus as you were baptized into his death and his resurrection. You became a participant of Christ's work for your salvation. And God gave you a promise. A promise of a sure and certain hope of better things to come. You see, you, my dear friend in Christ, were grafted into the vine, into the one true vine, Christ Jesus, in your baptism. This is what we sang on Wednesday in the first verse of our hymn of the day. O blessed spring where word and sign embrace us into Christ the vine. Here Christ enjoins each one to be a branch of his life-given tree. You see, you are no longer just you by yourself, even though we live in America in the age and time of individualism at all costs. You and I are now part of the vine of Christ, a branch that has been grafted into Jesus. And this is what gives us hope. This is what enables us to live in these end times that we find ourselves in with harmony, with like-mindedness. You see, in your baptism, God gave you specifically, sure and certain promises that are fulfilled in Christ Jesus. Those promises are these, my dear friends, forgiveness of sins. That's yours in Christ Jesus. Not because of anything you did, or anything that you might do in the future, or anything that I did or might do in the future, or not do in the future, but because of what Jesus has done for us 2,000 years ago. This is why we have this sure and certain promise of the forgiveness of sins. And because we've been brought to new life in the waters of holy baptism, we live that life today. It is ours. It's not perfect. It's not complete by any stretch of the imagination. But it is ours in Christ Jesus right here, right now. And God has given us the promise of salvation. Eternal salvation to all those who believe and trust in his promises fulfilled in Christ Jesus. This is your hope. You may not have thought this when you got up this morning and took your shower and put on your clothes and came to church, which was all through the power of the Holy Spirit, by the way. You didn't make that decision on your own. You would have much rather stayed in bed, but he brought you to this place so that you could receive that which you need, the forgiveness of sins. As you heard those words of absolution go over you this morning, your sins of thought, word, and deed, they were washed away once more. You were cleansed and restored into a right relationship. And the truth is, God promises that later today, when you and I sin, he says, I'll forgive those too. All because of what Jesus has done for you and for me and for all people. I have life today in Christ, but I'm hoping for a better life to come, my dear friends, because like you, I find myself in this fallen, broken world. This world where it's hard to have hope and harmony as we live out our lives in these end times. But God's promise to us is there's another life to come. It's an eternal life. It's an eternal life when God calls us to himself. When our soul leaves our body, the moment we take our last breath, our soul is with Christ, waiting for that last day. Because on that last day, there's more good news to come. Our bodies that went into the ground will be raised up, perfected, and glorified. Our soul will be reunited with our body, and we will be a perfect human being, the way God intended us to be from the very beginning, all because of what Jesus has done for us. We have hope, and we have harmony in this life that is ours in Christ Jesus, knowing that there's something better to come. And the salvation that awaits is beyond our comprehension. The salvation that is ours today in part will be in total when Jesus returns on that last day. So as hard as it is sometimes for you and I to live with hope and harmony in these end times, especially within our congregation that's filled with a bunch of sinners like your pastor who sometimes step on each other's toes, stomp on one another's feet, and punch one another in the arms, all proverbially speaking, of course. God's promise is that we can live in hope and harmony within one another because we have the forgiveness of sins, not just mine, not just yours, but all of ours. There is something better that awaits us, my dear friends. And this is why you and I can live in harmony with like-mindedness as we think about all of the promises of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. You see, we have, as beloved children of God, we have the true hope, my dear friends. As God's dear children, we have like-mindedness in Christ Jesus. And his desire is that we who have those truth, the true things of God, would take that out into the world, into our country, and into the world that lacks that hope, that doesn't have that harmony that you and I have. It's through you and me, through the power of the Holy Spirit, that God is at work to bring others out to that kingdom of darkness where there is no hope, except the hope of everlasting condemnation, to bring them into the kingdom of the light, the kingdom of Christ, the kingdom of God, where they can share all the benefits that Christ has already won for them and freely gives to them. My dear friends, you don't have to worry about doing the work. That's God's job, not yours. And he will accomplish his purposes. But he uses broken vessels like you and like me to share that good news so that others may have the hope that is ours. Or as Paul puts it at the end of today's reading, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. And if you'd allow me to pen his blessing and live in harmony in these end times that we find ourselves in. Amen. And the peace of God which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Please join me in singing our hymn of the day on 649, Blessed Be the Tie That Binds. Short introduction. Briefly. But it's all going to be under Edmund. Okay. All right. So if you will turn to the right to the reception of new members in your bulletin, we will continue our service with that at this time. Beloved in the Lord, our Lord Jesus Christ said to his apostles, "Whoever confesses me before men, I will also confess before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven." Lift up your hearts, therefore, to the God of all grace, and joyfully give answer to all to what I now ask you in the name of the Lord. Do you this day, in the presence of God and of this congregation, acknowledge the gifts that God gave you in your baptism?
Yes, I do.
Do you renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways?
Yes, I renounce them.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, and in the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I believe in God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Do you hold all the prophetic and apostolic scriptures to be the inspired word of God and the doctrine of the Evangelical Lutheran Church drawn from them and confessed in the small catechism to be faithful and true? Do you intend to hear the word of God and receive the Lord's Supper faithfully?
I do, by the grace of God.
Do you intend to live according to the word of God and in faith, word, and deed to remain true to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, even to death?
I do, by the grace of God.
Do you intend to continue steadfast in this confession and church and to suffer all, even death, rather than fall away from it?
I do, by the grace of God.
Do you desire to become a member of this congregation?
I do.
Will you support the work our gracious Lord has given this congregation with your prayers and the gifts God has given you?
I will do the help of God.
Upon this, your confession of faith, I acknowledge publicly that you are members of the Evangelical Lutheran Church and of this congregation. Receive the Lord's Supper and participate with us in all the blessings of salvation that our Lord has given to his church in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I invite the congregation to stand for prayer. Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for your great goodness in bringing these, your sons and daughters, to the knowledge of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and enabling them both with the heart to believe and with the mouth to confess his saving name. Grant that by your word and spirit they may continue steadfast in the one true faith in the fellowship of this congregation, as together we await the day when all who have fought the good fight of faith shall receive the crown of righteousness through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
These are some small gifts from the congregation for your family. We're going to continue in a moment with the blessing of our Lord Jesus Christ, and then we're going to turn and face the congregation. I'll introduce all of you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, you meet you. So, the names: James Edwin, Esther Alfred, Deborah James. We'd like to welcome you. Service will continue with the prayer of the church. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. I'd also like to offer an update. The Lord called another one of his beloved children home to himself. The Good Shepherd called one of his faithful sheep home to himself this past week, Lisa Sibin. The arrangements for Lisa is who's a relative of Linda Sanfilippo's, and will be at St. Paul Lutheran Church on Port Burgundy on Thursday. I looked for an obituary earlier this morning. I didn't find one, but I'm sure more information will be out. But you can certainly lift up the family for prayers for comfort and solace. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. God, our Father in heaven, look with mercy upon us, your needy children on earth, and grant us that your holy name be hallowed by us in all the world through the pure and true teaching of your word and the fervent love shown forth in our lives. Graciously turn us from all false doctrine and evil living whereby your precious name is blasphemed and profaned. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May your kingdom come to us and expand. Bring all transgressors and those who are blinded and bound by the devil's kingdom to know Jesus Christ, your Son, by faith, that the number of Christians may be increased. Lord, in your mercy,
Hear our prayer.
Strengthen us by your spirits according to your will, both in life and in death, in the midst of both good and evil things, that our own wills may be crucified daily and sacrificed to your good and gracious will. Into your merciful hands we commend all those who lead our country, state, and communities, and all who serve in the military, especially those who defend our country, including Katie, Colin, Brent, Mark, Kristen, Jacob, and Dalton. All those who are sick, injured, and undergoing medical testing, including Kathy, Linda, Chris, Kurt, Melissa, Billy, Dan, Irene, Ron, Shane, Alan, Larry, Bob, Donna, Renee, Jennifer, Donna, Martha, Jerome, Curtis, Candy, Deanna, Melanie, Madison, Patty, Bill, Justin, Joshua, Sean, Dylan, Macy, Mary, Cherie, Ron, Norman, Jamie, Ray, Carolyn, Mike, Gail, Dawn, Dave, Jeanette, Ken, Lana, Claire, Missy, Shane, Al, Dana, John, Marie, Rich, Midge, Ephraim, Martha, Olivia, Owen, Bonnie, Hayden, Max, Brittany, Cindy, Hannah, Jeff, Pete, Braden, David, Andrea, Bill, May, Kiyoki, Ruth, Jim, Susan, Peggy, Denise, John, Jojo, Joseph, Neil, Bob, Denise, Lee, Doris, Reverend Taglauer, Annabelle Balalu, Hu, Kai, Gage, Philip, Asherica, Cricket, Diane, Jean, Lottie, and Gail. For all those who mourn, especially the family of Ken and the family of Lisa. For all those who have personal and special concerns, including the Andrus family, Doug, Jordan, Joel, Emily, Jody, Isaiah, Brad, Ray, Philip, Sharon, the people of Ukraine, for those impacted by disasters of nature and man, for couples who long for a child, and for those who are with child, for all those who are homebound, including Eleonora, Donna, Jack, and Albert, for the ministry programs of this congregation as we seek to meet the needs of our neighbors, to shine the lights of Christ into a world of darkness and to bring peace into a world of tumult and turmoil. For all those who rejoice in God's gifts, especially the gift of a successful surgery for Ruth and for Jean, for another year of life for your servants in this congregation, David, Mark, Caitlin, Nancy, Jared, Marie, and Katie, and for all your missionaries, including Gadula, Linda, Anita, and Eva, and for another year of wedded bliss for those who are celebrating an anniversary this week, especially for Bill and Ginger, and all who are in need, praying for them at all times, thy will be done, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Grant us our daily bread, preserve us from greed and selfish cares, and help us trust in you to provide for all of our needs, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Forgive us our sins, as we also forgive those who sin against us, so that our hearts may be at peace and may rejoice in a good conscience before you, and that no sin may ever frighten or alarm us, Lord, in your mercy. Lead us not into temptation, O Lord, but help us by your Spirit to subdue our flesh, to turn from the world and its ways, and to overcome the devil with all his wiles. Lord, in your mercy. And lastly, O Heavenly Father, deliver us from all evil of both body and soul, now and forever. Lord, in your mercy. We trust, O Lord, in your great mercy to hear and answer us through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Our service will continue momentarily with the service of the sacraments of the altar. At this time, we would normally take up a gathering of offerings, gifts, and tithes to the people of God returning to the house of prayer. During these pandemic, post-pandemic, whatever days we're in, during these end times, we will continue to do that at the front of the sanctuary. As you enter, you may place your gift, tithe, and offering in the offering place located there. If you haven't already done so on your way in, you may do so on your way out, along with your attendance card to help us keep track of those that are participating with us. And also, for those that are worshiping with us from afar, we encourage you to continue to support the work that God has given us to do in this place by sending in your gift, tithe, and offering directly to the church office. If you'd like to drop it off, please call first just to make sure that someone is here. Now, our organist and flutist will give us a musical interlude as I prepare the table for the service of the sacraments for the altar. I invite you to stand as you're able for the service of the sacraments of the altar. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks to Christ.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should, at all times and in all places, give thanks to you, O Lord our God, King of all creation, for you have had mercy on us, and given your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Grant us your Spirit, gracious Father, that we may give heed to the testament of your Son in true faith, and above all, firmly take to heart the words with which Christ gives to us his body and blood for our forgiveness. By your grace, lead us to remember and give thanks for the boundless love which he manifested to us when, by pouring out his precious blood, he saved us from your righteous wrath and from sin, death, and hell. Grant that we may receive the bread and wine, that is, his body and blood, as a gift, guarantee, and pledge of his salvation. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, at his command and with his own words, we receive his testament. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Christ, our sins, our glories, glory.
also in St. Paul worship. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his countenance and give you peace.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for our closing hymn, 685. Let us ever walk with Jesus for a brief introduction.
Receive us and through sin.
Good morning once again. Good morning, Pastor. Glad you're with us. I'd like to especially thank those who joined us via our YouTube channel. The announcements are found on the back of your bulletin and the green sheet. And for those who are worshiping from afar, we do send out this information every week. If you'd like to receive via email, if you'd like to receive it, just send an email to the office. It's office@stpaulhammond.org, and we'll add you to the distribution list, and you get the whole enchilada, as they like to say. All right, the announcements are on the back of the bulletin. There's a calendar of events related to activities at St. Paul. And for those of you who got the voice message, we're going to be, December's a busy month, not just because it's Advent, but because we've got so much stuff going on. So you're going to get those weekly rundowns and reminders from the pastor via phone calls. And that's all that stuff's on the back of your bulletin and the calendar, hopefully. And also on the card tables, there's a tan half sheet of paper. Grab that. It has all these activities on it as well. For you to peruse, and also how we responded to God's love in the last week. Right after today's service, we're going to have our voters' assembly meeting, so stick around, all you voters. Don't everybody depart. We've got to approve an agenda and discuss a few items, which will be in your mailbox for a couple weeks. And then on the inside of that, will be on Wednesday, we'll have our midweek worship service at 11 a.m., which will be broadcast via our YouTube channel, and then also at 7 p.m., preceded by our soup supper. And we're meditating on the sacrament of holy baptism. Each week we take up one part of Luther's four-part response. It's great when that happens, right? 4 weeks in Advent, four parts to the catechism lesson. So this week we'll be on the second part. So hopefully you'll be able to join us at 11 a.m. or 7 p.m. or via our YouTube channel as we continue to meditate on what God does through holy baptism. And then Tuesday afternoon, we have our Bible study class. I know that was Wednesday, but our Bible study class is at 1:30 on Tuesday afternoon. We have a Board of Elders meeting at 6 p.m. In the church library, so hope you can join us if you're on the Board of Elders for that meeting. And then our normal stuff on Saturday, rather, before I get to Sunday. Saturday comes before Sunday, the last day of the week. So on Saturday, we'll be adorning our worship space for the season of Christmas, for the season of Advent. But we normally have our Christmas decorations up before our Advent Christmas, our Congregational Christmas dinner, excuse me, which will be on the 18th, on the fourth Sunday in the month. But we're going to continue to do that. So if you'd like to lend a hand and legs and bodies, not just the hand, don't drop that off, please. But we need the person as well. So to help adorn that, the sanctuary for Christmas, please join us 9 o'clock from 9 to 12. We're usually done before that, but it's just to give us some latitude to leave it. And then in your bulletin, there were two inserts. One was a purple one that looks a lot like this. This is a mission grant program through the National LWML, and it's taking God's word into remote and rural areas. And this is to help the Lutheran Bible translators, our entity and our church body that seeks to put the word of God into every native language. They're looking for a mission vehicle, and they're trying to raise $70,000 for that mission vehicle fund. So the loose change, the dollar bills, the checks, however you give, that money is going to help fund this project as well. So we give you thanks for doing that as God continues to do his mighty work in this world that we live in. Then the green sheets is a devotional resource for individuals, families, and small groups built around the orders of daily prayer in your hymnal. It has our reading plan to read through the Bible in 2 years. We finished up the book of Isaiah. We're starting the weeping prophet Jeremiah. We started that on Saturday. We'll be in with Jeremiah for a while as we hear his laments about the life of God's people and also his own life as a servant of God. So we hope you can join us in that reading. On the inside of those that requested prayers from the congregation in addition to the update that I gave you earlier with regard to Lisa Simon, we're praying for comfort and solace for her family during this difficult time. And then on the back are the announcements. We already talked about the congregational version. Don't forget, poinsettia order forms. We're pre-ordering 24 plants. If you go and visit your mailbox, which I know some of you haven't done because I see a lot of red half sheets in the boxes, which is the order form for poinsettias. You don't have to order one if you don't want to. That's fine. But we're going to pre-order 24. If you'd like to help offset the cost of that, you can fill out that sheet of how you'd like it dedicated, and each plant costs $6.75. That's due next Sunday. So we can get the order in case we have more than we've already ordered. So that's next Sunday. The flower chart for the upcoming year is available. It's over by the sacristy, between sacristy and the Fry Room on the bulletin board over there. You can sign up for just to give glory to God, remember someone's birthday or the loss of a loved one, anniversary, however you'd like to do that. Just indicate that on the chart. And then the food of the month for the Tangi Food Pantry is desserts and cake mixes. And then there's a stewardship thought for you, a life thought for you, based on our readings for, appointed readings for today. As God's word continues to speak into every situation you and I find ourselves in, there's no temptation that you and I face that Jesus didn't already face, believe it or not. That's what the Bible tells us. And so God's word continues to talk into these situations as we manage the gifts that God has given us. And the announcements. So today is the last day. And there's a beautiful wrap present out in the cross hallway, right? But if you picked up a sheet to buy Christmas gifts for children with CASA, that's due today. And so hopefully if you did that, you brought it in today so Ms. Marie can take it and deliver it so that it has time to get to those individuals in our community. Any other announcements? So pop quiz time, when's the next service? Wednesday, yes, Pastor. 11 a.m. and then 7 p.m. and the soup supper at 6. And we got a couple of things up there, a couple of good items up there. If you'd like to come and join us for a fellowship meal. Anything else? Any other announcements? Seeing no hands. I'm going to greet you in the back in a moment. And we'd like to ask God to watch over all of us as we depart this place, especially those that are worshiping with us from afar, that they will keep us safe and secure in his mighty right hand until we see one another again, and hopefully that will be in the near future.